Concrete has many applications in the construction of roadways, buildings, and landmarks. It provides strength and stability in many different forms, grades, and textures. From residential streets to interstate highways, concrete has been used as a durable, long-lasting paving material for over 100 years. But where does concrete come from? Concrete is made of paste and aggregates, or rocks. The paste that binds fine and coarse aggregate is made of cement and water. When first placed, the mixture is plastic, but soon a chemical process known as hydration begins, causing the paste to harden and transforming the mixture into a hard, durable, rock-like material known as concrete. By far, the most common type of cement used in the production of concrete is Portland cement. Portland cement is also used for other purposes, such as with sand, to make mortar for masonry. Let's start at the beginning and take a closer look at the manufacturing process for Portland cement. The first step involves mining of raw materials such as limestone, clay, and other materials. Limestone is typically extracted from a quarry by blasting.
Fire in the hole.
2 mine the stone on the west parcel, we drill a 5.5-inch diameter hole. We have a 145-foot face from the surface down to the floor. We shoot it all in one face height. It's typically on a pattern to maximize the fracture of the rock. We load it with explosives. We contain the shot by putting 3/4 stone at the top of the blast hole, and then we detonate it. And we then extract it with a loader and truck and bring it to our primary crusher.
From there, it goes to the surge pile and is transported using conveyor belts to the processing plant, where secondary and tertiary crushers size it down. The crushed limestone is shipped from the quarry to a cement manufacturing plant for the next step in the process, preparation of the raw mix. Based on the desired properties of the end product or cement type, the crushed limestone is mixed with select naturally occurring materials like clay, shale, sand, iron ore, aluminum ore, etc., in the right proportions and ground together into small particles to make them more reactive and blend evenly. Grinding is done in either a wet process or a dry process. Most modern cement manufacturing is done in a dry process by grinding in a dry raw mill or a series of dry raw mills until sufficiently fine. Some of the moisture trapped within the raw materials is removed during the grinding process by using a hot air furnace to supply heat or by recycling hot waste gases from the kiln or furnace. The raw mix is run through screeners to remove any large particles before being introduced into the kiln. The raw mix is transported by conveyor belt through a series of vertical cyclone towers to preheat the material on its way to the kiln. Preheating saves energy by recycling the hot exit gases from the kiln and heat from the coolers to heat the raw mix as it swirls through the cyclone towers. This kiln is where all the magic happens. The vast majority of cement manufacturing today is done in a rotary kiln, which consists of a large cylindrical steel tube lined with fire brick. The tube slopes slightly and rotates on its axis at a rate of 1 to 4 revolutions per minute. Raw mix is fed at the higher end, and the rotation and tilt of the kiln gradually moves the material downhill towards the flame at the lower end and succumbs the material to gradually increasing temperatures, as high as 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit. Modern kilns are greater than 10 feet wide, hundreds of feet long, and can run 24 hours a day, producing as much as 10,000 tons of cement a day. Under the extreme temperatures in the kiln, a series of chemical reactions convert the raw mix into cement clinker. First, moisture trapped in the raw mix is removed through evaporation. As the temperature of the raw mix increases, the clay and limestone decompose into calcium carbonate, calcium oxide, silicon dioxide, aluminum oxide, and magnesium oxide, releasing bound water and carbon dioxide gases in a process called calcination. With further increase in temperature, Portland cements two primary constituents, dicalcium silicate and tricalcium silicate, are formed in a process called clinkering. At these temperatures, other compounds melt, which causes the mix to conglomerate into lumps or nodules about the size of small marbles called clinker. The most important constituent of Portland cement is formed in the hottest zone at temperatures above 2,400 degrees Fahrenheit. The clinkering process is complete when all the silica is in the silicate crystals and the amount of free calcium oxide is less than 1%. The final step is the cooling process, where the clinker is cooled and the heat is recovered and recycled. The clinker solidifies to form the two other components of Portland cement. The rate of cooling from 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit down to 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit affects the cement properties, with rapid cooling resulting in a more reactive cement. Cooled clinker can be kept for several months without noticeable loss of quality if stored in dry conditions, making it amenable for shipping and trading in large quantities. Once the clinker has cooled, it is ground into a fine powder along with a small amount, about 2 to 8%, of calcium sulfate, such as gypsum, which is added to control the rate of early reaction of the cement. Gypsum also facilitates the grinding by preventing clumping and coating of the powder at the surface of the ball mill wall.
At that point, it makes its way into the ball mill, which is our finished part of the grinding process, and then essentially into a separator, which pretty much classifies the material and determines whether it's fine enough to make it as a finished product or it needs to be reground through the circuit again.
The grinding process is controlled to obtain a powder with the desired amount of fineness. The rate of initial reaction of the cement when mixed with water is directly proportional to the fineness of the cement.
Come in, TJ. Can you check W2 K-belt? Thank you.
Most of the process is automated and controlled through the central control room. Once separated, any material that is not fine enough can be ground through the circuit again. The finished product is stored in silos at the cement plant, where various batches of cement are typically blended together to even out small variations in the cement composition. From the silos, the cement is loaded by rail, barge, or truck, and transported to ready-mix plants to be mixed with water and aggregates to make concrete for a variety of uses.